Welcome back. So today we will continue our wallets and security. So before we continue, if you watched the last video, you know, I was trying to record it yesterday and then I noticed something. Again, it's my first time. It's my first time of seeing something like that. So I noticed that, okay, we created the MetaMask yesterday and also we created the MetaMask wallet, and then I tried to, you know, show you how to copy address, you know, how to send, transfer, and how to transfer tokens. But something I noticed was, now, I don't know if you noticed it. When I copied the address, I realized that the address gets changed. Now, it's just like, I remember I told you, your address is just like your account number. Okay, now, pick ball on like in Nigeria or in other in physical world where you have GT accounts, you know, you start maybe 00 whatever, you have to input GT. In crypto, it does not matter. One address works for everything. I get it. So it automatically got seen. I was like, what's happening? I get it. And at the end of the day, I had to discover that my system got infected with the Trojan virus. You know, it's a clipboard virus. Clipboard. You know, when you copy something on your laptop or on your phone, where it's saved. If, for those of you that you have a Android, again, you can see the clipboard there. So I know that it's a clipboard virus, and when you copy it, you just discover that it changes it automatically. Again, it changes it automatically. So it changes to the hacker's address. So, and if you are not very, very, very vigilant, this one is not a matter of you are an OG in crypto, you've been in crypto since 20 whatever, 2000, or in fact, you are Satoshi Nakamoto, whatever. Satoshi Nakamoto is the founder of Bitcoin. I get him. We don't know him. No one knows him. So no matter what, if you are not vigilant, you'll not be able to grab down, you know. So, you know, I told you that I was sharing it in groups so that people should be aware. And then someone messaged me that that happened to a friend. I get it. And the guy lost $2,000. That's like 1 million plus. I get it. Because, you know, you trust what you copied now. So you just copy and then you paste and then you send. And that's one more thing we are going to talk about in cryptocurrency. It is, blockchain is immutable. Immutable, that is, it can never be changed. Like immune, it can never be changed. Once it's gone, it's gone. You cannot reverse. In bank, when you do wrong transfer, you can call your bank. Then also, you fill a couple of forms. Maybe you get a police report. They will notify the other bank. Put a PND, post no debits on the other bank account, and then maybe the person will be forced to come out and, you know, refund the money. In crypto, it's gone. So I get it. So that we will talk about more of that in security. I will tell you the basics. I can't teach you everything. These people are getting wiser every goddamn day. I get it. So I can't teach you everything, but once I teach you the basics, then you pick up from there, and trust me, you have a stress-free this thing. Once you can just understand the basic, I get it. So let's go back to where we were yesterday. I was talking about wallets. I told you, cryptocurrency is not like your account number. Now, most of you know your account number of banks. And also, you know, my GT, my this thing. You know it often. When in cryptocurrency, you can't know it often. I get it. You can just know, okay, how many digits and it's like, you know, the letters or the numbers that end this thing. I get it. And that was if yes, you know, I know the number that this thing should be BO now. This thing should be this. And then it's copying something else. It's bringing D3. Do you get the logic? So let's just go back and start afresh. So you remember, I have MetaMask on my Chrome before. Can you see? I have it there. So I'm not going to use that. I'm going to start afresh my Mozilla Firefox, which I have downloaded. You can see, just go to metamask.io/download.html on whatever device you want to use. If you are using Android, no problem. If you are using your iPhone, so on and so forth. So then when you click the download this thing, install MetaMask for Firefox is an extension. We are going to look at it now. You can see, so just click add to Firefox and it's working. It's working. So let it continue working like that. Let it continue working like that. It's adding to Firefox. Trying to get my pen. Okay, I got you. Thank you. Wow, is my network acting funny? It should. Let me try. And let's see. Okay, the network is working fine. So I think it's the. Add to Firefox, come on. Okay, sorry, add. It's bringing notification. This extension will have permission to access your data. No problem. Input data to clipboard. No problem. Add. So we will add to, you know. Okay, good. Just press OK. Now, it's telling you, just like yesterday, it's telling you that, okay, get started. Welcome to MetaMask. Okay, no problem. Get started. Now, look at it. Just like yesterday, do you have a secret recovery phrase already? If you have, you import wallet. I get it. You import wallet. I get it. But if you don't have, which we are going to create a wallet. Just, I agree. Yeah, we agree. We don't need it. So, let's type in the password again. No, I remember I told you Binance. We use Binance. Binance is in Binance. 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 Oh God. Binance. Binance. And I read and agree to the terms of use, even though you did not read it. That's it. Don't save. I get it now. He's going to tell us next. You click to reveal your secret phrase, your recovery phrase. Now, you see this recovery phrase. Once you have it, I get it. Once you have this recovery phrase, you don't need to bother about your account. Wherever, you see, if you are in New York, I get it. You are in New York City, you are in Canada, you are in wherever you are. If you have another wallet, I get it. Another crypto wallet. Now, this is not about MetaMask now. Another crypto wallet entirely. Once you input this phrase, you'll be able to recover that account. I get it. So that's the beauty of crypto. So let's just write it and click property D mimic radio inflict furnace jelly kite pigeon sofa and arara dwarf. Okay, so you click next. Don't think we are similar, that we have to, you know, input it accordingly. So we can see the mimic radio, sorry, mimic radio inflate furnace jelly kite pigeon sofa dwarf, and then you are going to see it's confirmed, all done. I get it, all done. That's it. Now let's see. You can copy it. Can you see? Now, look at this. What? Look at the last four digits here. OC1D. You can see OC1D. OSC3F. OSC3F. So that's it. That's, are you getting? That's a kind of reassurance that yes, I am working with the right token. Are you getting? Now, if you can just take a look back at the previous video, at this point, I can, if you can pause and go back to the previous video. Now, let me show you how to import wallet. I get it. Like, you can just, you know, import accounts and look at it. Now, you have to paste your private key string here. You have to paste your private key string here. Okay, no problem. You will still come to that. I will show you the different types of keys that we have. You can create another account. I get it. Let's say account 2. Let's say this is Zoom account. Create. Good. We've created this. Look at the address. Can you see that the address is different? 87AO ends this. So let's just look at the 87AO and OSAFA. Can you see that the account is they are different? Can you see it now? Good. You can switch accounts here. Account one, it moves here. Account two, our zone account. Are you getting it? That's that. Now, the other thing is, you can get this account private key. Now, I told you that. Now, if somebody wants to say, "Oh, I want to send you some token, I want to send you ETH." Look at the name. ETH. Are you getting it? Remember, ETH is Ethereum. Look at it here. Let's type it out. ETH. Can you see it? ETH is Ethereum. Can you see it? That's ETH. Now, if somebody, let's go back to our MetaMask, just click here. And you, are you seeing it? You can see the way it's displaying now. You can see it. Now, let's say someone said, "Oh, I want to send you something." You just copy the address, send it to the person, and you get in. And the person will send you the token. Simple as ABC. Now, let's say you want to get your private key here. I get you want to get your private key, like you want to move to another account or the another wallet. You just click here, go to settings. I get in settings, look at it, privacy settings and wallet secrets phrase. Okay, then you can just review secret phrase. If you ask us to type our page, Binance. Can you see? Clark property, same thing. This is not what I want. Okay. You can get the private key. There is another one, private key. What the fuck? Account details. Export private key. Now, this is our address. That is our token address. If somebody wants to send money to you, this is what you send to the person. I get him. If it's ETH, export private key. Let's type in Binance. Confirm, and that's it. That's our private key. I guess that's our private key. Click to copy, Control C to copy. All done. So, take a note of this address, please. 87AO, right? Good. Let me delete this stuff. Let me delete it. No, sorry, let me delete it. Listen. I want to delete it so you can, I want to delete it. Where is this? A moment. Okay, sorry. Okay, I've expanded it over here so that I can see it very well. Okay. Move to settings. Advanced settings. You see, security and privacy. Alert. Network. Okay, let's really talk about network. Remember, I told you that in cryptocurrency we have different chains. Again, we have different chain. Now, this Ethereum chain, are you getting this Ethereum mining? This Ethereum chain, I get this Ethereum chain. Now, you might want to maybe add another chain, maybe Binance Smart Chain. You just click add a network. You have this network name, this chain ID, Block Explorer, New RPC, I get, and then you input it. Again, you input it. Let me quickly show you something like that. BSC, RPC, MetaMask. Just search for it. He's going to bring it. It's not something that is hard. Now, look at the name. Connecting MetaMask to Binance Smart Chain. I can connecting MetaMask to Binance Smart Chain. So, while we wait for that one to to load, the network is acting up. Wow, no internet, that's awesome. Okay, moment, let me just. It should go. It should go. It should go. Good. Look at it. Connecting MetaMask to Binance Smart Chain. So you have to configure the wallet. And it's straightforward. Are you getting? Look at it. Select settings from the drop down menu. On the settings you want to locate network, click add network. So it's straightforward. And this is what we are going to go because mainnet. This is the one we are probably looking for. No problem. That's exactly the one we are looking for. So what do we do in this command? We can just, look at it. You can also come here, add network. I get in add network. So then we can start copying. Smart chain. Oh God. Smart chain. New RPC URL. You have the new RPC URL. You can see everything is just intuitive. That is straightforward. Our chain ID is 56 and symbol is BNB. 56 and symbol is BNB. Save. Can you see it? Look at the address. Look at the address. Look at the address. We have the same address for different crypto. This is Ethereum mainnet. Same address. Are you getting? Same address for the smart chain too. Are you getting? So that's just it. And look at this. Look at the name of BNB. Look at the name BNB. So what it simply means that now if I type BNB coin market cap, you will see the coin now. Can you see it? BNB. So that's it. That's how you do things on your, on your MetaMask. I'm still trying to. You come here, you can add network and do a sort of this thing. Do a sort of thing there. So that's just it's wallet. And remember, I told you have Supreme kind of wallet. You have Trust Wallet is another one you will be using often. It's the same way you do. You use it the same way to create wallet or import wallet. You can download for your App Store, for your Play Store, and the all the likes. So that's it. That's it. Nothing much to say. That's it. Now let me show you something. Let's try to visit a website. Are you getting it? Let's try to visit a website, a crypto website where you will be PancakeSwap.finance. Let's look at PancakeSwap.finance. You getting PancakeSwap.finance. Now look at it over here. It's saying what connect wallet, like connect wallet. Okay, what are you going to do? I'm going to connect my wallet. Can you see it's asking us what do you want to use? MetaMask, Wallet Connect, Trust Wallet. Now remember I told you we have another one, Trust Wallet, right? But I'm going to, because I'm using MetaMask, I'm going to click MetaMask and it will pop up automatically here. So it's now asking me which account did I want to connect to. Is it here or here? Okay, let me choose here. Next, connect. And that's it. Look at my address now popping up here. I get in my address popping up here. So you can then, so you say my BNBTC is low. You can then start trading and do all sort of whatever. So that's basically how to connect your wallet on this thing. Also, if you want to use Trust Wallet, is it Trust Wallet on mobile? It has its own browser. I get it has its own browser. And then once you click it, you just everything is just seamless. I will show you that too. Now that's how it wallets. That's how it's wallet. Now I have to go to security. You have to go to what? Security. You have to go to security. You have to go to security. Now, one more thing in wallet before we move to security is this immutable. When you say immutable, let me so that you can see. Immutable meaning that is unchanging over time. But let's look at it. Unchangeable, fixed. Blockchain is immutable. Anything that is stored there is stored there for life. If you transfer so BTC to a mistakenly to a wrong address, like yesterday, that the token is changing my address. I get it, that the virus is changing the address. Now, if you transfer it there, the money is gone. Remember, I opened some sites yesterday and I was trying to figure out some things yesterday. Yeah, this is scam address. I get it. This is Block Explorer. Explorer is just like maybe you are checking your transaction history on your phone. I get it. Now, on your bank account, you are like, ah, did I transfer money to somebody? Did I do this? When did I transfer? You want to know the time. You want to know how much you transfer. You want to know the charges. This is it. Again, this EtherScan. This is a Block Explorer. We call it Explorer. Again, a Block Explorer. This is Block Explorer for Ethereum chain. I get it. And look at this particular address. You can see this particular address is having 3 Ether. That is $16,000 worth of Ether. Another token is $2,000. This same address, if you look at it on BSC scan, BSC scan is the, let me copy it there. BSC scan is the blockchain explorer for Binance Smart Chain. Can you see Binance Smart Chain Explorer? You just input the address there. Look at it. Can you see it? $10,000 in BNB and other tokens. Now, if you notice, I checked the comment because you can make comments there. You see some of the comment now. Look at this particular one. This is ARK. No? This is ARK. When you make autocopy from MetaMask or other wallet, they put this address. Again, they put this address. So that's just it. Again, so that's just it. That's the Block Explorer. Now, like I said, immutable, you can't revert back. You can't go back. Because you remember when I explained blockchain for you? Blockchain. When I explained blockchain for you, let me look at the, let's look at the images again. There is one particular image I used to explain. Now look at it. Imagine this is block 1, block 2, block 3, right? Is that not so? Good. Now, let me show you the number of blocks that BSC scan that Binance Smart Chain has produced. Let me show you. Look at it. Latest block. What is this? Latest block. 39, that's 13,128,993 blocks that has been produced, and it's produced a block every 33 seconds. If I should refresh this now, can you see? Can you see this 29,000? Let me refresh it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it's still loading. Can you see? No, let's just look at it here. Block. So now take for instance, maybe I made a mistake in my transfer ATM this morning. Then that means you are telling me that for me to readjust, to make to rectify that, we have to cancel all these blocks that has been produced. It's not possible. I get it. It's not possible. And look at it. Look at this particular block. Look at the number of transactions that is inside. 617 transactions. That's the number of transactions that is inside. So that means you are literally saying, okay, let's say 617 people transfer token. I get it. Is that's the total number of transactions that is in this block. Now, because me, I made mistake at 8 a.m. They will not cancel all this. They will cancel this. They will cancel all this. Just to go and it's not possible. And even the validators are different. You know, validators are witness. Remember, in our mining, they use sophisticated equipment, I guess, with computer and all the lights, you know, 247 light, 247 electricity, 247 water supply, you know, cooling system to cool down the whole system. when they are mining, the computer does work automatically. Now, what they do is they accept transaction before. That's what I have mentioned there. Look at it. I mean, transaction 617. So 757. They are the one that are accepting the transaction. And in order to you know, reward them, when they accept transaction, they surely get a certain reward. For example, look at this one. 617, you got how many? 1.3769 BNB as reward. I get it as reward. So you can see validator stake to me. Fuji, BNB 48, BSC Scan, Satic, Cisco West, and so on and so forth like that. So that's it. It's immutable. That's why you have to be very, very, very sure of what you want to do in crypto. Because if you a single mistake, the money is gone. The money is gone. No one can help. Good. Now, let's move to security. We are done with immutability, mining, and wallets. Let's move to security. Now, I remember saying something, greediness, you don't have to be greedy in crypto. Remove greedy, any form of greediness, just remove it. Because if you are greedy, we are rational beings. We know what is right and what is wrong. I get it. We know what is right and what is wrong. Someone is coming and promising you everyone it. Your mind is telling you, this thing, be careful. Where you're like, ah, it's quick, you know. These people, they don't mind. They do the math like, okay, if I can get $5 from 300 people, if I can get $5 from 10,000 people, but your own $5, you'll be like, ah, if it's $5, it's not much. It's just 2,000 naira. Now do it. 2,000 times 10,000 people. Just do the math, and then you realize how much they are getting. So first of all, eliminate all sort of greediness in you. And first thing first, keeping your key safe, your private key, security phrase. The one they give us is called phrase. That, clerk, property, day, mimic, radio, and so on is called phrase. But you see this one here, that is one here, this particular one, account details, okay, this export private key, I get it, this one here, it's called private key, let me show you that real quick, okay, see, I think I have. No, let's just use this one. Alright, just use this one. Okay. Account details. Export private key. He's asking us to type. This one here is your private key. You copy it. Now you have to. I know some of you ask, where would I keep it? First of all, the best form of keeping things is not keeping it all online. Some people keep it in their email. Yes, they keep it in their email address. What if your email gets hacked? You think it's impossible? People spend thousands of dollars just to scam. Hundreds of thousands of dollars just to scam. In crypto world, they will design a good website that you should connect your account. And once you connect your account to the scam website, your money starts going. Or connect your Gmail account, and you know, maybe you are trying to log into somewhere and they say connect your Gmail, and then you connect the Gmail account. Now your Gmail account already has all your private key, and then you just realize that they're already removing all the tokens in your wallet. So that's why I do advise people, if it's a diary, you have a diary. Are you getting it? Now your security phrase, that maybe 12 letter word phrase or 24 letter word phrase. Write it out in your diary. You can have three diary, put one at home, carry one with you, or you just keep it in different places so that they can't all get misplaced at once. So keep it, write it out. Now you see that private key that is mainly that, print it out. For goodness sake, you are talking about, it's your money. So you can do it anyhow you like. Maybe feel like, is this not much? Treat it the way you treat your bank details. I know many of you want to withdraw at ATM, and if someone is close to you, too close to you, you are going to, you post what you are doing, say, Mr. Ma, please, can I have some space? I can just move back a little. Are you getting? So, do the same thing. It's not too much to ask for. Print it out somewhere. Keep it there. Simple. Or if it's to copy it on your on Microsoft Word, copy it on Microsoft Word. Copy it out from the system. Save it on a maybe external hard disk somewhere. Keep the external hard disk. Simple. That's that on the private key side. Now, what about the in crypto? The funny thing is, we don't even need the private keys before they scam you. They will just ask you. Look at this site now that I connected. If it's a scam site and I have money in my DC, they would have withdrawn the money. Look at here. Please make sure you are visiting PancakeSwap.finance. It's a phishing warning. Because there are many sites that pose as PancakeSwap. You see, maybe PancakeSwap. Okay, this is not a. I just want to guess a PancakeSwap. Let me say PancakeSwap phishing site. Look at this now. PancakeSwap. Let's look at it. PancakeSwap. Oh, it's not available. It's not available. Of my internet usage policy. Fuck off. Sorry, it's not allowing me to view it. So I think it has seen it like this site is not a. This site is not a safe. Thank you. But that's it, you see it, and then you'll be like, oh. Connect, and then when you connect, so you have to be very careful of what you connect to this thing. You remember I told you there is something called airdrops. Airdrops. So there is something called airdrop. This is one of the methods that they using, you know, getting access into people's accounts. Because now, okay, look at this one now. And remember I told you zksync.seal. Striking, come on. Okay, maybe the site has been taken offline. Yeah, I think so. It has been taken offline. It's like ksync.say. I get it. It's like a head road. Okay, just connect to this thing, transfer so amounts of this thing. And the people fear for it. Because, you know, airdrops in crypto world. Some airdrop can make your life. You know, people giving airdrops worth $30,000. Are you getting? So people want to go extra mile. So you see some, they will tell you that, okay, transfer 0.01 BNB for wallet confirmation. Are you getting it? Fine, you feel like this, you transfer it. You transfer it. Is that not so? Now let's look at it. 0.01 BNB. Imagine You have, you see, funny thing, those people spend money on advertisement to advertise this to many people. Now, at the end of the day, you see like maybe 20,000 people falling for it, 0.01 BNB. And then you have 200 BNB. Now, when you look at BNB price, 200 BNB. Are you getting it? No, change it to dollars. Change it to dollars. Okay, in Naira, that's 50 million Naira. So many. So many. So you just have to be very, very careful. If it's too good to be true, you leave it. And now I do advise people that, see, let me tell you, creating wallet is very easy. Creating wallet is very, very easy. Look at me now. Look at me. This is my MetaMask. I get it. Look at it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 wallets. So if I want to use do a particular, why can't I just, my daddy is with me, then also, and then I will create a new wallet. So I know that if anything should happen from that site, they are on their own. Is that also? I know that they are on their own. They are not taking anything out of my hand. But now imagine where you have money. You use them for hairdo, use them for this. And then at the end of the day, when they scam you, they will just pack all your money. I am telling you things that happen on a daily basis in Nigeria, WhatsApp group, with people I know. I get things. You see them coming like, I've lost some money. You see some $3,000, $10,000, yes. That they move from people's accounts. And what can you do? What will you do? What can you do? You can't do anything. Because the money is gone. The money is gone. So you just have to be very, very, very careful and vigilant. Careful and vigilant. Take that time. Relax. Look at it. If you are finding any difficulty to know if it's legitimate or not, then you can send me a message. Just beep me on WhatsApp. I'll reply you. I get it. I'll reply you. I will surely reply you. And then create new wallets for any airdrop that requires connecting accounts. Connecting accounts. And when it also comes to send token to something, run away. Run away. Why would you want to give me something? You ask me to drop money. No, think about it now. Think about it. Okay. Yes, let me just say. Hello? Hey, we are calling from ABC Enterprises. Yes. We are conducting a survey. Okay. For our new product that we are about to bring out. And yes. Can we have 10 minutes of your time for the if you are successful completion of the survey, we are going to give you a 20,000 naira. Yes, we will forward your account number. You forward your account number to us, and we give it 20,000 naira once you answer our questions in 10 minutes. Yes, we just have 10 minutes to just ask you some questions. Okay, good. But before we start, please, you will have to, you know, we will forward you our account, so you will send a 550 naira a day. I get it as confirmation, yes, that you've not participated in this survey before, because we don't want someone, you know, doing it more than once. Look at that. That's bullshit. That's what bullshit. Tell the person that 20,000 naira you want to give me, remove that 550 day. Simple as ABC. I get it. That's simple as ABC. Because why will you want to? You say you want to give me a, you want to give me, and you're not asking me to pay something 0.05 or whatever. Why can't you remove it in this thing? So you just run away. You know it's scam. They know. Okay, don't worry. It's you that you think is cheap. When we collect that 550 naira. We collect it from 10,000 people. And we know that it's money now. Is that not so? So you just have to be very, very careful. They come in different aspects. Different aspects. Or what about this? On Telegram, if you have Telegram and when you are not into crypto, you meet the different scammers. You can just enter a Telegram group, like a WhatsApp group, and you see, you have problem. You tag admin now. The admin might not reply. You see some people, they will quickly enter your DM. Again, they will quickly enter your DM and start asking you questions. Hey, please, this thing. How can we help you? That's why you see most admin, they will put it in their name. Don't DM. Let me show you that in a moment. Yeah. So as I was saying, they will put it in their this. Now this example of a Telegram. This is my Telegram I get. This is my Telegram. Now let's look at this. This guy here is an admin in this Telegram group, Uswap Finance. Okay, see. Now look at the name. JJ, do not DM first. I get it. So they put it there. It's a kind of tricky stuff. They put it there so that any because you see, these people they play on other people's intelligence. I get it, especially newbies, people that are just in the crypto world. Look at this guy picture. They will copy the picture, put it. This same name, they will put it. But how do you know if it's real or not? You see, JJ do not DM face the same thing. So now, when that person has sent you a DM, does the DM mean direct message, private message? When that person sends you a private message, won't you know that it's a lie? Now, okay, come now. You said that you don't DM face, that you don't send message face, and you are now sending message that no, this is nonsense. Are you getting it? So that's it. Other way, go back to the group. On Telegram, you always have the person name. Okay. Look at it. This is the person name. And even with this, you cannot be very, very sure because this will be just clean. This JJ now, you can see the C at the back, they might just put it in small letter. Or sometimes, okay, take for instance, you have the person name is. Now look at this. I type two different things. I type capital letter I and small letter L. Look at that. So that's a most crypto admin. That's what they do. They put do not DM first there, so that you know that no, this person will not send a message. Will never send a message to you. So any message you see, you know, is definitely from scam. From all these scammers. So I'm trying to see if we can look at this again. Shredded Pepe never DM you first. Can you see it? So that's it. They will put it there. It's a kind of technical that okay. They know that the scammers will quickly send to your private message that how can we help you? You have to do this, you have to do that. Oh God, they say you are not DMing me. Why are you sending me? You just block the person. Block and report. Very easy on Telegram. I get it. Very easy on Telegram. Now, the next thing is there's another one. You can be on Telegram and someone will just send you a message. Hi. There's an investment opportunity I wanted to show you. Report and block. Simple as ABC. There is another one. Okay. My boyfriend broke up with me. And we have to also a month in the. In the website, in a trading this thing, you will see a functional website. They will build the website, and then the person will say you should go there and register. Fine, register. The person will tell you that you should send your address there. You copy the address and then they will send you the token, the Bitcoin or whatever token. You will see it there. They will not say, hey, please help them to withdraw that. You will not share the money 60-40 because they trust you, no problem. Now, that's where business comes into it. Somebody that do not know you will send you tokens, well, maybe $5,000, maybe $10,000, maybe $50,000, $100,000. And it's okay. So, after you withdraw it, you should take 30%. You should send the 70% to him. It's okay, no problem. But do you know you'll not be able to withdraw that money? Instead, the exchange, the website will ask you that before you can withdraw, because they can just say one policy because of one new rule, whatever, that you should deposit Bitcoin or any other token to withdraw. My brother, if he deposits his, your money has gone for vanishing. I get it. Your money is gone, trust me. Your money is gone. If you deposit it, it's common sense now. I want to withdraw $50,000. You're not asking me to deposit 5 naira or 100 naira to withdraw 50,000. Who is fooling you? But because of your greediness, again, because of your greediness, you're seeing 50,000, you're seeing it. And I'm like, wow. Oh, see money. Are you getting? You're seeing you to you. Your money is gone. So those are the, just know the basics. Don't be greedy. If you are encountering any this thing, then you can send me a message. I will surely answer you. Are you getting? So that's all about wallets and security. That's all about wallets and security. Ensure you know the site you are going. Don't download any other wallets. On Play Store, there are many fake wallets there. Are you getting? On Play Store, you want to go to a site, type it directly on your site, on your address bar. And also cross-check. Because maybe another virus is there that is changing the address. Just like the virus that starts changing the wallet address. You want to go to binance.com. binance.com. Boom. Enter it. You want to go to kucoin.com. KUCOIN.COM. Boom. Press it there. Don't be lazy. Don't be lazy to cross-check. Don't be lazy. And that's it. Binance. That's it. Do you remember Binance from our exchange this thing? So they are the owner of Trust Wallet. So it's the largest exchange. Binance is the largest exchange out there. So you know that at least they are Trust Wallet. They are owned by Changpeng Zhao. This KuCoin is another decent exchange too. And Changpeng Zhao. It's you know of Binance, CEO of Binance. I can call him CZ. So that's all about security and this thing. Just make sure you keep your things. And not only that too. You keep it safe on your own physically too. You don't try to get it. Your phone that your wallet is not like your bank account, but you are carrying it all about. You have 10 million naira there. It's just like saying you put 10 million naira in your pocket, you are not going to Oshodi. Are you getting it? Now, you do not protect you do not put password on your this thing, you start flaunting it. It's just like saying you have 10 million naira in your pocket, maybe you wore a mini skirt or small jeans, and then you pack like maybe 5 million in your hand, and then you are walking like that. Trust me, you will not issue it before the key inside the bus that you enter. But if it's Uber that you carry, the Uber driver will kill you and steal the money and go. Trust me, they'll kill you. Yeah, doesn't it kill you? Yeah, this one is more. So you have to, in fact, it's not even to, you don't need to let people know you are doing crypto. What is that? You don't need to let people know you are doing crypto or whatever. Make your money. That's just it. Look at things. Keep everything cool. Pass out your phone. That's it. Then you have this thing. But now, see, that Bitcoin. You don't need to. Now everybody knows that one is in crypto. And then at the end of the day, you plan for you how to steal your phone. And when they steal your phone, unlike your bank listing, that maybe they need your something key to send whatever your password. Just be cool and calm and, you know, don't just. Thank you. Bye.